Hi, I'm Hazel, and today we're going to be taking a look at a new feature on the 8.1 PTR, a Seafarer's Dubloon Vendor. For you to spend your doubloons at, they're not going to sell you doubloons. I don't know why you'd want that. After the patch goes live, you'll see a shiny new vendor located near your Island Expedition queue table. Horde will deal with Captain Zentaga found here, just outside of the little table hut thing. Alliance get Captain Clarissa standing right here, just opposite the table. Before we get into what they offer, there's two important things to know. First, this is PTR, and the prices in particular may or may not be final. Second, the existing mount, pet, and toy drops from Island Expeditions are not on this vendor. This is for buying new stuff that's being added in 8.1. You'll still need to have those original collectibles drop the old-fashioned way if you want them. So, you can purchase a few types of things from this vendor. First is rep items, and these are the only thing that is not new to the patch. For 100 coins, you can buy an item that you turn into a BFA faction emissary in exchange for a grand total of 250 rep. These are the same items that we're already dropping from expeditions. This sounds like a massive waste of doubloons. It might be the thing to get after you have everything else. We are getting Paragon rep caches in 8.1, so you could have rep towards that. I'd like to see either much bigger chunks of rep or a much lower price before this is worth it for me. Next, we have transmog, specifically these tricorn hats. So these are transmogs for your player character. They are not, as I initially hoped, the beginnings of a battle pet transmog system. There is a hat-wearing rat named Tricorn, and that is unrelated. You can get these in red, gray, or blue, and they should be just the thing for your pirate transmog, and those go for 100 doubloons each. We've also got a selection of toys. For 150 doubloons, you can get a hand anchor with a 1-hour cooldown that says use the anchor as a weapon. My best guess is that this replaces your weapon model with an anchor model for some amount of time. However, I am personally hoping for some kind of animation where you slap someone with an anchor. I need that for Raid 9. For 200 doubloons, you can get a cranky crab. This is a mount for your pets. We've had toys for your pets before with the Felcazar spoons, but this is the first time that we've gotten our pets mounts. It's got a 10-minute cooldown, and I cannot wait to play with that. For 300 doubloons, there is a gnarlwood waveboard. That allows you to surf across the water. My guess is that this is similar to the angler's fishing raft toy, although it may or may not allow fishing. We'll have to wait and see. Next, there are two pets that you can get. For 100 doubloons, we have the Crimson Octopode. This is a red octopode with blackened tentacle tips, and I need it. His moveset is not the same as the Octopode Fry. This one has access to bubble, which is always nice. For 200 doubloons, there's the Albino Desk Watcher. This one is a white raven model with some flying moves, but also has access to Drain Blood and Blood Fang, so a decent amount of healing. And finally, there is a mount. For 500 doubloons, you can purchase a Saltwater Seahorse. Assuming that this functions like the Poseidon Seahorse, it's just below Vashir Seahorse speed in Vashir, but matches the standard underwater mount speed everywhere else. That makes it still slower than the Underlight Angler Shark Talent. You could say that I am salty. While we're on the topic, if you never got the Reins of Poseidon, they are much easier to get these days, and they also sell for a lot less. Might be worth taking a look if you're interested. So if you want to collect all of the transmog, toys, pets, and mount from this vendor, you are looking at 1,750 doubloons, which ought to keep you busy. With the exception of the rep items, the Horde and Alliance vendors sell identical stuff, so at least you only need to grind on one faction. While running your expeditions, consider focusing on hunting rare mobs and events over generic Azurite if you have the wiggle room. There are reports that that can raise your chance of seeing the special loot items. And that's why you should save your doubloons. What's a consumable buff worth when you could save for a crab mount for your pets? Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think. Check out my channel for more WoW videos and live streams, and have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye!